Hi, my name is Dakota Baker, Assistant Chief Instructor at Sporty's Academy, and welcome to the next edition of Ask a Sporty CFI. In today's lesson, we're going to be discussing the differences between a soft field takeoff and a soft field landing, and what their techniques require. You may be asking yourself, why do I need to demonstrate or know anything about these techniques? According to the ACS or Airman Certification Standards, you may be required to demonstrate one of these types of techniques or maneuvers on your next check ride. In today's example, we'll be using a standard Cessna 172. The soft field landing technique is a little different but similar in many ways to your standard landing procedure. You can apply the same procedure for your downwind and base legs of the traffic pattern. The approach should be stabilized on the extended runway centerline, no lower than 300 feet AGO when turning final. It is important to follow the final approach speed specified in your pilot operating handbook for your type of aircraft. It is essential to maintain your final approach speed all the way down into ground effect. Touchdown should occur at minimum airspeed with the aircraft in a nose-high pitch attitude. Maintain back pressure on the yoke to keep the nose wheel off the ground until it can no longer aerodynamically be held off the field surface. At this time, it should be gently lowered. It is important to avoid the use of brakes and use power if necessary when taxiing on very soft fields. If you come to a complete stop on your runway and it is soft enough, your wheels could sink far enough into the ground where you are stuck in need of a tow. A few helpful soft field landing techniques involve leaving a little power in to help cushion the aircraft's descent onto the runway. Or, if you're still a fan of bringing the power to idle when the runway is made, you can always reapply some throttle as the aircraft descends down to the runway. It is important to remember that it is a controlled descent onto the runway rather than a full stall landing onto the runway, which we would see with normal landings in a 172. Always remember that a grass strip will always have different visual cues compared to a paved surface. Always remember a successful soft field landing starts with a stabilized approach. Don't be afraid to go around until you feel confident in your approach. A soft field takeoff, on the other hand, is all about transferring the aircraft's weight from the wheels to the wings as quickly as possible. Always follow the correct procedures and recommendations per your aircraft's POH. In our case, the Cessna 172 POH recommends 10 degrees of flaps. Flaps will help increase lift as the aircraft accelerates down the grass strip. Apply back pressure as throttles increase to full power. Applying back pressure will in turn raise the nose wheel off the ground, creating less drag as the aircraft accelerates. As power is applied, the back pressure may need to be adjusted to prevent a tail strike as the power comes into full. Maintain enough back pressure to keep the weight of the nose wheel off until the airplane lifts off. Upon liftoff, lower the nose so the aircraft can build sufficient airspeed before climbing away.
For more flight training tips and information on Sporty's courses, visit studentpilotnews.com.